capturing the architect of the Holocaust, undoubtedly one of Mossad's greatest achievements. Adolf Eichmann was arrested in Argentina in 1960 and brought to Israel. He was tried and executed in 1962, the only time Israel has carried out the death penalty. Rafi Eitan was head of that Mossad operation.
If we wanted to kill him, we could kill him quite easily. But we wanted to take him into trial, and that's much more difficult.
10 years later, what became known as the Munich Massacre. Palestinian terrorists killed two Israeli athletes at the Olympics in Germany and took 9 more hostage, demanding the release of 200 Palestinians. Israel refused, and all of the athletes were killed in a bungled rescue attempt by the German military at the airport.
It was evidently planned very well by the terrorists, and our boys paid for it.
Israeli Prime Minister Golda Meir is believed to have ordered Mossad to track down the killers. In 1973, 3 Palestinians were killed in Beirut, including Mohammed Yusuf al-Najjar, head of Black September, the Palestinian group which carried out the attack. 3 months later, in Lillehammer in Norway, Mossad agents killed the wrong man, a Moroccan who had no connection to the attack. 5 agents were caught and imprisoned, but released to Israel 2 years later. Mossad waited 6 more years to get the right man, killing Ali Hassan Salameh in Beirut.
Throughout the years, Mossad earned himself a reputation of efficient and ruthless intelligence agency with, quote, license to kill.
But an attempt to poison Hamas leader Khaled Mashal in Jordan in 1997 failed spectacularly. The Mossad agents were caught, and Jordan's late King Hussein forced Benjamin Netanyahu, prime minister then as now, to send the antidote to save Mashal and release Hamas's spiritual leader Sheikh Yassin, a man who Israel killed a few years later. Danny Yatom was head of the Mossad at the time and ordered the hit.
No, I'm not sorry at all. I think that no terrorist can enjoy any immunity, and they should know exactly that the free world will chase them if they continue to execute terror attacks.
He agrees with the policy of ambiguity when asked about operations.
Everything should be hidden because it is an unlawful operation in any other territory.
Current head of Mossad, Meir Dagan, is saying nothing. By remaining silent, there are less likely to be international repercussions, and any international agency in the world likes to keep their targets guessing. Paula Hancocks, CNN, Jerusalem.